so great to be here. Felisa, hello. Hola. Kia ora na. Bulabanaka. Tarofalaba. Shesheni. Sincha. All the welcomes of the world. Welcome. And it's a real privilege to be here. And just like Lansing, we just have something for everybody. And we're just a group of young people that don't know a lot, but we just know that we love God and that God loves us. And I want to share with you Psalm 101, verse 1, it says, I will sing of your love and justice, and I will praise you, Lord, with song. And so a lot of us here on the stage that they have come up, you know, we know how powerful music is. We've visited people in hospitals, we've visited schools, public and private. We've visited prisons, and we've just sung our hymns. We've just sung our songs, our choruses, with instruments and without instruments. And we know that when we've sung to these people, that the music had been a smooth balm to their hearts. So that is our prayer tonight, that the music will just encourage you, empower you, and just to let you know that God is for you and not against you, and that the words and the melodies and the intention behind it, look, we're not here to do a show. We are here just to glorify God and to lift Him up, and He will draw us to Him. The song is called Smile. If you don't want to sing that, here we go.
Today's a new day. There is no sunshine, nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a gold mine. Today's a new day, but tell me, where are my blue skies? Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright. I almost feel wrong, and how do you get it right? It comes from heaven like a shower.
And so, I'll start with this young lass here. What's your name?
Hello, I am. My name is Cassie.
Yes, so where are you from?
I'm from Australia.
But your mother's from?
Patelru.
Oh, in Patelru, yes. Kia ora. And so what part are you going to sing for us tonight?
I'm going to sing the part of the violin.
Take it away.
The violin's ringing like a lovely sea. The violin's ringing a lovely song.
Not too shabby. Young girl over here, and your name is?
Moala.
Fantastic. How old are you?
I'm 22.
I'm 23. What about that? And what part are you going to sing first tonight?
I'm going to be singing the part of the clarinet.
The clarinet, the clarinet, goes la-di-da-di-da-di-da-di-da. The clarinet, the clarinet, goes la-di-da-di-da-di-da.
Fantastic. And you, young handsome man over here, what is your name? Please tell the people your name.
My name is William.
And William, what do you do for a living?
I am a youth pastor. Moment.
A youth pastor for what church?
Pepstar.
Fantastic. And what part do you sing for us tonight?
I will be singing the trumpet.
Take it away, youth pastor.
The trumpet is playing, ba 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 bidi ba 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 bidi ba. The trumpet is playing, ba 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 bidi ba 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 ba.
Wow, 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 hello, how are you?
Hello, I'm good.
And so where are you from, young man?
I live in Sydney. You know what I've been Sydney for? Yeah.
Do you not hold that against her?
Please, no.
But where's your family from?
So my mum comes from a little place called Rotorua. Yeah. All my family down here, and then my dad comes from the East Coast.
Fantastic. And what part are you going to sit for us tonight?
I'm going to be playing a part of this year.
Sue, take it away. Wow, amazing range. Moving on, moving down, moving out. Young, beautiful lady, what's your name?
Kayla.
And your surname?
Kayla.
Okay, Linda, have you heard this girl make some noise? Okay, how old are you?
18.
Fantastic, I'm 18. And so what are you doing this year? Are you going to be moving to?
I'm moving to Adelaide.
Okay, you're not sitting. I'm going to get it. Okay, fantastic. What are you going to study?
Business.
Ooh, fantastic. And what part are you going to sing this time?
The flute tonight.
Because it's very, very cute. Take it away.
The flute is very, very, very cute. The flute is very, very, very cute.
Singing it down. It sure is. Were you in a movie called Moana? Are you Maui? No, I'm only kidding. Wow. Okay, sorry, Lord. Tell us about you. What is your name?
My name's Ronald Ryan.
Oh, Ronald Ryan. Are there any Ryans in the house tonight? Even if you're not, just make someone. Okay. All right, and just how old are you? And what church do you attend? Fantastic. Yes, he is a faithful guitarist every Sabbath. And what part are you going to sing for us on?
I'll be doing the part of the drums.
We'll take it away.
The drum plays just two notes and always the same notes. So do, do, so, 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 so low.
Fantastic. We've heard all the parts, so now we're going to put all of them together. Okay, we're going to put all of them together to create our North New Zealand Conference Vocal Instrument Band. Here we go.
The violin's ringing, the clavier's singing, the
endless orchestra, and it rhymes with instruction. Can anyone say what it is? Not. Oh, sorry. Okay, my bad. Yes, it is the conductor. We're looking for a conductor. We are looking for a conductor for this band. Is there anyone that is willing? Is there anyone that is available to say yes to being a conductor? Come on up. If God is impressing you, you come on up. Yes, yes. Someone's pointing at you again. Oh, I'm getting a bit scared. Okay. Well, I'm just going to go around and pick someone. Thank you for lunch. What was that, God here? Yeah? Okay. Sorry, no, not here. Dwayne Strickland, come on. Not Dwayne, Caleb Strickland. Come on, yes. Oh my gosh, there's so much tension. We're not asking you to preach, we're just asking you to conduct for this sake. Oh, thank God, Caleb, biblical name. Come, hi to mine. Come on. Okay then, so this is where you're going to choose to conduct the orchestra. If you want us to go loud, like this, side to side, if you want us to go soft, side to side, if you want to go slow, if you want to go fast, you know, it's up to you, it is Sabbath, okay? Just be led, okay, are you ready? Can everyone just give them some encouragement? What's your name? Caleb Strickland, where are you from, what church are you part of?
I'm part of Maranatha.
Fantastic, and married?
Oh yes, my beautiful. She wanted to do this.
Okay, she wanted to do it, but no, she's not. And how many kids do you have?
Three kids.
Fantastic. Let's give them a big round of applause. Turn around. Oh no, yeah, let's actually put it on the stage. Just more lighting.
No. to join in with some praise, with some worship to our King with us tonight. Is that okay?
It's all right. Good. Oh, you tell the person next to you, tell them that you love their numbers. Now, tell them that you love their outfits. Tell them they look great tonight.
Thank you. to the floor. You know, we have, sometimes we come to our wits and we have nothing. But it's at that point where God just says, come to me. It's in those moments in time where the Spirit calls, come to me. So if we're in this place tonight where you're at that point, the King is right here. Right here, right here, right now. This is your prayer tonight. Sing with us. Take him to the King.
Take me to the King. I don't have much to breathe. My heart is torn in pieces. Is my offering. Take me to the King.
Truth is I'm tired. I choose a few. I try to pray, but where are you? I'm all transplanted, hurt and abused. I can't fake what's left to do.
Truth is I need no strength to fight. No tears to cry, even if I try. But still my soul refuses to die. Oh, one chance will change my heart. Take me to the King. I don't have much to bring.
about my story and a little bit about where I come from. I'm going to try really hard not to cry, because this is just a bit of a crying story. I haven't actually spoken about it just yet. It's a bit fresh. But so as Ladine said before, I come from Australia. It's alright, you don't have to fake it. Okay. So I come from Australia, I come from Sydney, Australia. But as Ladine said, yes, I am half Kiwi. My mum is from so yeah, I spent a lot of time growing up coming to New Zealand and I hated it. I thought it was so boring because of that town. And but I love it now. I love New Zealand. It is a real honour and privilege for me to be here and to share this platform with such amazing people. Yeah, just to share my heart, be able to worship and do that in your space. So thank you for having me. So I'm going to share a little bit about my story. So yes, I come from Sydney, Australia, and I grew up there my whole life. And growing up, I had a really awesome childhood. You know those kids that you look at school and you're like, man, they got it. They got a good, you know, two parents, we love them, they got all they could ever need, and not everything that you want, but, you know, everything that you needed. I grew up in a safe, secure space, really, really, really happy, beautiful childhood. And I come from a family that loves to travel, so I spent a lot of time as a kid, you know, traveling all over the world, because that's what my parents did, you know. A lot of families, they save for different things. You know, fancy houses, fancy cars, my parents stayed for the holidays. So we spent weeks and weeks and weeks overseas. And just really beautiful memories, really awesome time. And when I was about 13 years old, my dad got really sick. And, you know, I remember sitting there and I was only 13. And, you know, my parents coming home and telling us that my dad wasn't well and that he had cancer and all those kinds of things. And it was only 9 months later that he passed away. So I was 13 years old and, you know, had this amazing life, this amazing family and childhood. And then all of a sudden, that was torn apart. For me, anyway. I remember feeling like everything was over. The whole world had ended because this had now ended. And it was hard. I remember just thinking, oh, I just want it to be, you know, a year or 2 years later, I just want to be over this yuckiness that I feel, you know, I just wanted it to be happy land again, you know, but it wasn't. This was now, you know, what my life was going to be. And by any means, it wasn't a bad life. It was a bold life still. You know, my mom was amazing. And so carried on, I had an amazing opportunity to join Endless Praise, which I did when I was 17 years old. And I stayed in that ministry for 10 years. And full-time ministry on the road, away from my home, away from my family, just doing ministry. And it changed my life, made me who I am today. It taught me so much. And it showed me how real God is. You know, people always say, how do you know that God is real? And I said, you have no idea what I've experienced. Being on the road for 10 years, the way that you have to rely on God is just incredible. And no one can ever take away from me what I've experienced. And I know without a shadow of a doubt how real God is, because I have experienced Him in that way. God is so real. And so we would travel around and I would sing this song that I'm going to share with you tonight. And I would share this testimony and sing about, you know, how faithful God is. You know, when I would look back at that time when I was 13 years old and just see how faithful God had been to me, you know, keeping our family together and being there with us through that time. And I would sing this everywhere that I would go. And now we move to me today as a 32-year-old. And you know, a couple of years ago, my mom got sick, and here we go, and the whole process started, and, you know, my mom passed away in March. And you know what, guys? I don't focus on the tears, focus on the words. I now had to live what I had sung for all those years.
I had told everyone around the world how faithful God was. You know, and it was easy to do because I was an adult. I wasn't 13. I wasn't 13 anymore. I was looking back and reliving that and seeing God in that. And now here I was in this all over again. You know, I never thought that I would be 32 with no parents, but I am. And that's okay. That is okay because I have Jesus. You know what? God is so faithful to me, guys. God is so, so faithful. I can tell you, to go through this again is probably the hardest thing I've ever had to do. But God is so faithful. He is so faithful. He has once again walked every single step of the journey with me again. And you know, there's a story in the Bible about two guys, they're walking back to this town called Emmaus. And Jesus has just died. Their best friend, they're everything. He has just died and these two men are walking and this man starts coming and walking along with them. And he turns to them and he says, "What's wrong with you guys?" Because they look really down. And they say, "How can you hurt, you know, that guy that everyone's been talking about, that guy, our guy, Jesus, he's gone. He passed away." They kept walking back to Emmaus. And once they got there, they invited this strange man into their home to come and share a meal with them. And the Bible reads that as they are sitting around and they are about to give thanks for the food, that this man, he broke the bread and their eyes were opened and they realized that it was Jesus himself that was sitting there right in front of them. So many times, guys, we are walking to Emmaus. I have been walking to Emmaus for like 3 years. You know, it's a hard road. But trust me when I tell you, whatever it is that your road is, look, it might not even be someone losing someone. It could be anything. Know that God is walking with you. He is walking right there next to you like he was with those two guys doing this. Sometimes we don't see him or feel him or know him, but trust and believe he is walking that way with you because the God that we serve is a faithful one. So if anything, I want you to feel uplifted and I want you to feel encouraged to know that this is what is, you know, this is what has come to pass in my life with Jesus. And the same God that I serve is the same one that you do too. So be encouraged, okay? This song is called Emmaus. And I really do hope that it's a smooth bump, too salty.
Showing me that you
scribes and the Pharisees. They wouldn't dance if they wouldn't for the king. I came for the fishermen for drink and dawn. They came with me and the disc went on. Dance then wherever you may be, for I am the Lord on the dead sea, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dead sea. I danced on the Sabbath and I cured.
Be able to speak in all.
guys enjoy tonight. I hope your hearts are enriched and your lives are blessed. I love what's on the backdrop here. It says harvest. It's time. Can you turn to the person next to you and say, it is time. It is time. It's time. Harvest. Whenever I think of that word harvest, I think of this word mission. Can you say mission with me? One, two, three. Mission. And as I begin to think about mission, I love what Jesus says in the word where he says, I am the way, the truth, and the what? The light. He also says that you, talking to his disciples and his followers, that you are the light of the what? The world. And as I think of this concept of light, I love when I grew up, I actually grew up in the church, and I love going to the school that we went to out west, the White Tech, and they said that they went to school. Yeah, White Tech. Very small school. I think we had about two classrooms, and there was about 30 kids in total. So you can pretty much be everyone. But I loved the songs that we sang. And one of the songs that I loved singing was the song, This Little Light of Mine. And just from an early age, I had this idea that we were to be the light. That our purpose as Jesus followers is to be this shining light. But as I grew up, I noticed something very interesting, and that's this. Is that we love to shine light where there's already light. We love to shine light where the light already is. And I just want to share this verse with us all. It's in John chapter 1. And John says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him, all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The light shines where? In the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Did you know that light shines best in darkness? Light shines best in darkness. So as you're thinking about this idea, this theme of harvest, I'm telling you right now that the harvest isn't where the light is shining. The harvest is in the darkness. And I know the darkness is messy. The darkness is scary. The darkness is going to call you out of your comfort zone, but that's why Jesus said that I am the light, because it's not you that's going to shine the light, it's Jesus shining his light through your life. So this song that we're going to be sharing is a song called Use Me. The song talks about this desire and this passion to be used by God, and it talks about the story of Moses when God used him to free the Egyptians. Oh, sorry, to free the Israelites from the Egyptians. And this man who was once afraid and who once was scared, but God said, "What is in your hand?" And he said, "This is my staff." And God used him. And I'm going to tell you tonight that God can use you to shine your light in darkness. So our prayer as we sing this song is to challenge you to think, what is the dark places that God is calling you to shine your light? And shine that light as bright as you can for God.
If you can use anything, Lord, you can use.